How's it going, everyone? It is Panjano here, and in this video, I'm going to be covering how you can fix your Nvidia drivers if you happen to be experiencing many of the recent Nvidia GPU driver issues, such as black screens, flickering issues, game crashes, PC crashes, either to a black screen or to a blue screen, or if things just don't seem to be the same on your PC as they were a few months ago. This video is aiming to help you fix the current driver issues with Nvidia GPUs. If your GPU is having a software-related issue, this video should be able to fix it. Get Windows activated for a great price with WhoKeys. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10, or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options, including PayPal, are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to WhoKeys for sponsoring. Before we jump into things, please do note that this is a fix video. If you haven't experienced a serious drop in performance, game crashes, loading errors, or unstable PC games, there is no benefit to doing this. If your system is completely stable and fine, keep your system as is. But if you happen to have heard any friends or family members that have experienced problems like this, please do share this video with them so you can get them back on a stable system. The first two things we need to do is to remove the driver which is causing the current issues on your system. We then need to replace that driver with either an older driver before the major driver changes came in, or the absolute latest driver available for your GPU. An older driver will more than likely give you that stable experience, but you might not have the absolute latest optimizations. Whereas with the absolute latest driver at the time of you watching this video might have fixed all of the problems anyway, and you're just a few updates behind. There's no harm in trying an older driver or a newer driver, as you can simply repeat the steps in this video to try out the other option if you happen to replace your driver with one that still causes the same issues. So first of all, we need to download the driver we're going to be installing. For this, head over to Google and search for Nvidia drivers. Head to the nvidia.com driver page. It does not matter which of these pages you're brought over to because the steps are the same. Head down to the manual driver search section. We then need to select our product type, which is GeForce. If you're not entirely sure which GPU you currently have installed to your system, right-clicking on our taskbar, heading to Task Manager. On the left-hand side, go to the Performance tab. Scroll down towards the bottom to your GPUs. You'll then be able to see an Nvidia GPU. On the top right-hand side, you'll be able to see the make and the model of the GPU you currently have installed. For you, this could be a 30 series, it could be a 40 series, whatever this is the information you'll be using. So for me, that's a GeForce RTX 40 series, and it's an Nvidia RTX 4060. Select the operating system you're currently using, select your language, and then select Find. Inside of this section, at the top, you're going to be shown the absolute latest driver at the time of you watching this video. So if you want to go with the latest driver, you'll simply download the one found up here in the top. Instead, if you want to go with an older GPU driver, this can be found by navigating towards the bottom to view more versions. For those of you on an Nvidia RTX 40 series or older, I would recommend scrolling down until you find driver version 566.36. So go with the absolute latest driver, or if you want to try the older driver, go with version 566.36. And if you're on an Nvidia RTX 50 series, go with the oldest driver available to you, because the driver versions which are available to you will be slightly newer because those GPUs have just launched. For me in this video, I'm going to be going with the older driver, but if you went with the absolute latest, that's completely fine. Make sure it's the GeForce Game Ready version, select View, and download the driver on the left hand side. Whilst your driver downloads, we now need to download DDU or Display Driver Uninstaller. This is the tool or utility we're going to be using to remove our current GeForce Nvidia driver from our system, the one that's causing us all of the issues. Just simply search for Display Driver Uninstaller. You could choose to use the Guru3D link or the official wagnardsoft.com link. Both are fine, but I'm going to be going with the wagnardsoft.com official link. Once inside of here, go to Read More. Scroll down slightly to click here for Download and Support. Scroll down slightly again to download either the portable version or the installer version. Either is completely fine. I will be going with the portable version. Once that's finished downloading, put both the driver and the DDU onto your desktop. Start by double-clicking on DDU and selecting Extract. You'll then be given a DDU folder on your desktop. A quick tip, if you happen to be playing any particular games that you have optimized settings for or settings that you don't want to forget, boot into those games and either use your phone or your screenshot key to take a picture of current settings that you're using in many of your favorite games, because you might find that many games actually reset their settings when you install a new GPU driver. With that out of the way, I would recommend that you disable your internet connection temporarily. The reason we're going to be doing this is because once you uninstall your current Nvidia driver, when we reboot into Windows, Windows will detect that you are missing a GPU driver. It will then automatically try to install an outdated driver, which we do not want, because we're going to be installing our own driver. So to stop that from automatically happening, we're temporarily going to disable our internet connection. If you're using an Ethernet cable, you can simply unplug it from the back of your system, but if you would like to disable your network temporarily on the system itself, whether it's Wi-Fi or Ethernet, right-click on the Wi-Fi or Ethernet icon, select Network and Internet Settings, scroll down to Advanced Network Settings, and just simply choose to disable your Ethernet and or Wi-Fi. Once that is disabled, we now need to reboot into Windows Safe Mode. The reason we need to use Safe Mode for the best results is because we're going to be removing the display driver we are currently using. Doing this without Windows Safe Mode will mean that you aren't going to be removing most of the files because they're still being used. You can do this by holding the Shift key on your keyboard on the left-hand side, press and hold this, press the Windows button, right-click on the power button, and select Restart. Continue to press and hold the Shift key until you're met with this screen when your system restarts. You can now let go of the Shift key. Head to the Troubleshoot section, Advanced Options, Startup Settings. Select Restart. Your system will then restart once again. Under Startup Settings, we're going to be selecting Option 4, so press number 4 on your keyboard. Log in as you typically would. Inside of your desktop in safe mode, head over to the DDU folder, which we got earlier on, and open Display Driver Uninstaller. You can then exit out of the general options. On the right hand side, we need to select our device type, so that's a GPU. We then need to select the brand of GPU that we're using. For this video, it's going to be Nvidia because we're uninstalling our Nvidia driver. Once that's been selected, go to the top left hand side to clean and restart. This is then going to remove your current Nvidia driver. This will not stop your display from working. As you can see on my screen, I'm currently using the HDMI port on my Nvidia GPU. All we then need to do is wait for DDU to finish up and wait for our system to automatically reboot into standard Windows. You'll notice that your resolution still isn't full. That's completely fine. Log in as you typically would. Once you're on the desktop, we can now install the GPU driver that we downloaded earlier on. Whatever driver that you downloaded, we can now double click on it. Select yes. Select OK. The first page you're going to be met with is going to be if you wish to install the Nvidia graphics driver and the Nvidia app, or just the Nvidia graphics driver. Now, because there are many issues with current GPU drivers from Nvidia and some issues with the Nvidia app, for now, I would recommend just going with the Nvidia driver on its own, because you can download the Nvidia app from their website afterwards at any time and install it in just seconds. Select Nvidia graphics driver, agree and continue. I would just go with the express installation, but you can go with custom for any reason if you want to select certain options, and select next. Throughout this process, your screen may flicker a few times, the resolution might change, and that's all completely normal. Once the installation is complete, select close. You can then choose to either keep or delete both DDU and the driver you downloaded on your desktop. That's completely up to you. What I would then do is right click on the desktop, go to show more options, and select the Nvidia control panel. Select agree and continue. If you happen to be utilizing things like G-Sync, you can go ahead and set that up as you did before. The main options we're going to be going into the control panel for, though, are change resolution. Underneath this option, I'd recommend that you set your default native resolution for the monitor you're using, whether that's 4K, 1440p, 1080p, or whatever it might be, and select the maximum refresh rate available for the monitor inside of here. Go to the bottom right, then select apply. If you happen to be using any custom Nvidia control panel settings, you can go ahead and set those back if you wish to use them. At this point, all we now need to do is go to the bottom right and re-enable our connection. So go to network and internet settings. If you unplugged your Ethernet cable, plug it back in. Go down to advanced network settings and just enable the network adapters that you disabled earlier. You should then automatically be reconnected back to your network within a few seconds. Once you've made sure that your resolution and refresh rate are correctly set and have made any adjustments that you wanted to in the Nvidia control panel, before we do anything else, quickly restart your system just so everything can detect your new GPU driver properly. We can then go back into any of your favorite games and get back to using your PC how you typically would. If you happen to have any games that were specifically causing you issues, do retest those games now because it'd be a great indication of whether or not that issue is now fixed. Remember to utilize any screenshots or pictures that you took earlier to make sure that you can set your game settings back to what they were. If you happen to run into any of the issues that you did before, you aren't completely out of luck. All I would recommend that you do is rewatch this video, go through the same steps of using DDU, but go with the opposite driver than what you just did. So if you went with an older driver and it doesn't seem to have fixed your specific issues, redo the steps with DDU, but go with the latest driver. And if you went with the latest driver and you're still getting those issues, try out an older one and see what works best for your system. For those of you on select RTX 50 series GPUs that are still experiencing black screens, you could potentially make use of Nvidia's new firmware update that they have just released, but that is only recommended for those of you that are explicitly getting the issues described in the firmware update. I won't be showing it in this video, but it is worth knowing that this is an option if you're still running into issues. Let me know of your system specs and which GPU you are using and the issues you had, and let me know which driver you went with, whether it's older or newer, to fix the problems in the comment section down below. If you're now looking to get more performance out of your Nvidia GPU, check out the playlist section in the description down below or click on the video on screen, and I'll see you in the next one.